Utilities Chairman Senator Will Parkinson held an oversight hearing specifically on GPA's plans to curb the recurring threat of brownouts. GPA had a detailed presentation of how to shore up the system while they wait on the ultimate solution, completion of the massive Ukuru power plant. But in the meantime, GPA General Manager John Benavente wanted to make one point very clear. Despite their best efforts, vendor bid protests keep bogging them down.
Down the road here and ready to award, and then somebody protests, you know, then we're dead in the water again.
The most recent case in point, a 40-megawatt solar project that would have shaved the peak load but was derailed by a protest.
The OPA decided in our favor. We went, then they took it to court. The Superior Court, of course, again decided in our favor. So here we are, over 2.5 years later, and the project could not go forward. So what did the people, what did the ratepayers and everyone in Guam lose? Over $100 million. No? Yeah. Why? Because it's unreasonable that anyone will hold their price for 2 years. So we won the battle but lost the war.
Parkinson was still concerned about accountability, though. Benavente says they are accountable to no less than two independent regulating bodies, the CCU and the PUC. But what they really need, he says, is the legislature's help in fixing procurement rules that are skewed too much in favor of vendors.
Though I have been critical of GPA today, I fully believe in giving you guys the help you need, and I'm fully pushing to get 201 and 206 passed. I had previously requested an expedited placement of the bill on the agenda, and I'd even requested for an emergency session. I was denied on both of those, but I have now gotten 201 on the session agenda, and I do believe it's on its way to passage in the legislature. And 206 will be soon after as well, sir. So you will be getting the help you need.
Parkinson made a last-minute move at the previous session to discuss his two bills, but was shot down by colleagues who didn't believe he was fully prepared to lead the deliberation. His bills would provide for the repair of a much-needed diesel generator and the construction of temporary emergency power generation. Nestor Lecanto, KUAM News.